So end behavior of, we were looking at our power function here. So I use p of x was ax to the n. And so I'm going to make a more organized table than we had last time. We did make a table of values, so maybe I need room for that. I'll make our table, graph, and end behavior. So I'm double underlining the important columns. What you're going to need at the end of this is, depending on if A and N are even and positive, or odd and negative, or other combinations, that'll affect the end behavior. So we saw A positive, N even. I'm not going to repeat the table. I will redraw the graph. We got 0, 0, and wherever A was, we got 2 points, and this is supposed to look like similar to a parabola. So there's the graph. End behavior, just ignore the center part of the graph, and the end behavior, stuff happens in the middle, and it goes up on both sides like that. So that's with positive and even. Now we'll go negative even. So the way to think about even is the ends match. They're both up in the positive case, and in this case, they're both going to be down. And we'll see that by making our table. So when I plug in negative 1, so I have negative 1 to an even power gives me positive 1. So in this case, when I plug in negative 1, I'll have a negative 1 to the n, which is regular a. And the next one, a times 0 to the n, which is 0. And the last one, a 1 to the n equals a. So we got our point 0, 0. And now when I want to graph a, you have to remember a was negative. So a is going to appear on the negative part of the y-axis. So a is going to be somewhere down here. So we'll say that's a. It's less than 0. So here is what our graph looks like. And this end behavior, you draw your cloud, and it's going to go down on both sides. So there's our end behavior. My cloud's supposed to be modeled after the Mario villain that sits in the cloud. I think he's a Koopa. Does anybody know Mario lore? Is that right? Lucky two. He's what? Lucky two? But he's a Koopa. Yeah, he's like a lizard guy. No? He's a cloud guy or gal? Okay, obviously. Somebody get to the bottom of this. All right, so we have n is odd and a is positive. So we're going to plug in negative 1. What is negative 1 to an odd power?
Negative
1. Negative 1. So it's going to keep the negative sign. So this is going to be negative a. Next up, a times 0 to the n is 0. That one's easy. And last, a times 1 to the n is just a. So when we graph this, we got the 0, 0 point. Now, I assumed A was positive, so that means A is going to be somewhere up there. We're going to need negative A, which is going to be down there. So we got 1A and negative 1, negative A. Now, the way these connect together, they don't quite go in a straight line. They have a curve to them, and it's going to look like this. So the end behavior we have for this graph, on the right, we are going up. On the left, we're going down. So the best way to remember evens is the sides match, both up, both down. And the best way to remember odds is they don't match. One's up, the other's down, or vice versa. So odds, they don't match. Evens, they do match. And the other way, evens are parabola. So it looks like a happy parabola or a sad parabola. So last up, A less than 0, and is odd. All right, one thing I could do is I could just make my table of values again. However, let's think about transformations. What would be the difference if this graph right here was ax to the n, and all of a sudden I multiplied by negative 1? What transformation? So if I graphed negative p of x, what transformation does that negative sign correspond to?
Vertical.
So what vertical transformation?
Stretch.
It's going to be a stretch. And what type? So negative 1, it's not going to make it taller or shorter, but what will that do? So another way to think about it is negative 1 times that original function. So you're going to take all your y-coordinates, multiply them by negative 1. So it's going to flip across the x-axis, or reflect across the x-axis. So whatever's at the top is going to flip down to the bottom. Whatever's at the bottom is going to flip to the top. So we're just taking a vertical reflection. So we still have 0, 0. And our end behavior.